So what causes myopia or nearsightedness to get worse? Or why is it that some people's glasses prescriptions seem to always need to get stronger and stronger every year? Myopia or nearsightedness is indeed becoming more prevalent worldwide, with some estimates showing that up to 50% of the world's population will be nearsighted by the year of 2050. But why? Why is this happening? And what can we do about it? Well, the reason that myopia is getting worse really comes down to two factors. First is genetics, which research has shown accounts for about 20 to 35% of the risk of developing myopia, which means that if one of your birth parents is nearsighted, you yourself have a much higher risk of developing it too. And if both of your birth parents are nearsighted, then you even have a much greater risk of developing myopia. And the second factor that plays a role is, of course, lifestyle, particularly our lifestyles at a young age, because the window of the most eye growth and change occurs during our adolescence. And without question, our lifestyles have changed dramatically as human beings over the last 150 years or so, especially for our youth while they are growing up. Namely, things like being more sedentary and spending more time indoors, but also increased amount of demand for near work activities, which includes both our education as well as the amount of time we spend up close during our leisure activities, which honestly has only gotten worse with the adoption of smartphones, laptop computers, and mobile gaming devices. Research has continued to show us that both these two factors, genetics and lifestyle, play significant roles in not only our risk of developing myopia in the first place, but also our risk of having stronger and higher levels of myopia, which not only result in higher levels of glasses prescriptions, but also results in a greater risk of developing several eye diseases that we reviewed in my last video on the myopia pandemic, which includes things like cataracts, glaucoma, myopic maculopathy, and retinal detachments. Now, the exact reason that being sedentary and spending more time indoors and just increased amounts of time doing near work causes myopia to get worse is not fully understood yet, but we do know that there is some sort of signaling that goes on from the eye to the brain that controls how collagen develops and the eyes change, especially during our adolescence younger years. And as I reviewed in the previous video, as the eyeball grows longer, the greater the risk for all these different eye diseases goes up. All right, so what can we do about it? Are there ways we can slow down this myopia pandemic? Certainly our lifestyles are unlikely to change because our modern world requires our population to pursue higher education as well as spend increased amount of time on things like our smartphones and our computer screens. And it's just, that's unlikely to change. So thankfully, research and medical science has shown some cool ways that we can slow down myopia. In the eye care world, we refer to this specialty as myopia control, or even better, myopia management, which is really an accumulation of multiple different strategies that your eye doctor can prescribe therapeutically for someone like a young child to start slowing down their progression of myopia. And even with some good luck, can hopefully halt it altogether. And maybe even if caught early enough, could stop myopia from forming to begin with. These techniques include everything from prescription eye drop medications to special types of glasses lenses that may be available to special contact lenses that can help. And even in investigational research, there is some interest in things like red light therapy that may be beneficial as well. And if you're not already a subscriber to the Dr. Eye Health channel, then do so now, because soon I'll be coming out with a video going more in depth on all of these different treatment options so that you can know a lot more what options might be good for you and your family. And if you turn on the notification bell, you'll also be notified when that video comes out. But for now, I do want to leave you with a few things. First is that myopia is a concern at all ages, but usually our rate of myopia development slows down considerably in our early 20s. And the window for us to make the greatest change at slowing down myopia occurs when we are young children. So if you happen to be a parent or a guardian, here are a few tips. Number one is to encourage your child to spend more time outdoors every day. research has shown that spending more time outdoors can reduce the risk of myopia onset. Try to aim for at least 2 hours outside every single day. Number two is to try to limit the amount of time a child spends doing near work, especially using digital devices outside of just their normal schoolwork. In fact, the American Academy of Pediatrics recommends no more than 2 hours of entertainment media a day. And I think it's a great kind of thing for the whole family to set as a goal, as a way to achieve this. And finally, tip number three is to have your child's vision checked regularly. Vision screenings at school and even at the pediatrician's office are good, but they are very, very basic and oftentimes can miss eye and vision problems. So it's good to have a full eye health examination by either an optometrist or an ophthalmologist by at least the age of kindergarten, even earlier if possible, because catching eye and vision issues early on during those critical times of development can have ripple effects that'll affect the rest of a child's life. Now from here, if you want to learn more about the different types of glasses or contact lenses or prescription medications or therapies that eye doctors can prescribe for young children to slow down myopia, then go ahead and click or tap the screen over here to this side. Otherwise, I hope you found this video educational and informative. Thank you so much for joining me. Keep an eye on it, and we'll see you in those next videos. Peace.